The head librarian gestures to the man beside her. Mr. Sadler would like a word before you head out. His generous donations make our expeditions possible. Sadler gestures to the door behind him. We've arranged transport to the spot on the Braelish border where the manifest zone was detected. Good luck. You've arrived at the Braelish border, near the manifest zone created by the Eye of Mebar. Now to find the Sovereign Host Chopper. The Eye is said to be kept. A pack of ravenous wolves springs to attack. The chapel appears undamaged, but an eerie silence blankets the area. Perhaps the Eye of Mebar is still stored inside. The kitchen was abandoned suddenly. Food sits out, half prepared. A fire has been laid in the hearth, but it's unlit. Someone carefully removed the wall here, revealing a vault. Of the vault reveals that the Eye of Mebar is no longer here. Yet the Mebar manifest stone makes it clear that the Eye must be somewhere in the area. Perhaps you can learn more in the hamlet that is said to be nearby. Trees have been cut here, presumably to make the freshly built palisade that surrounds the hamlet. Before you can try one, the ambush defeated, gate no longer locked. Thank you. of a secret village. The village is left behind a hideout. As the cell door opens, hidden hand prisoners make a break for freedom.
No mercy, no anger! Focus!
With the lever pulled, the doors to the armor creep open. Quell rises with a pitiful wail of rage and despair. Quell dissipates with a final defiant cry. The barrier, sealing off the manor hall, fades away. The undead have turned this corner of the armory into a makeshift torture chamber.
Hands. It's the only pleasure I have left.
The skeleton hisses as you approach. The eye is mine. By right of conquest, I will sacrifice my plans to some paltry pack of latecomers.
Your tiny form cannot take much more.
Ah.
You have retrieved the Eye of Nebar.